So there are two groups of risk factors that we need to think about for the people of New South Wales. Those over which we have little discretion, and those which clearly are lifestyle factors, and each of us make those decisions. With the first group, we need to think about age. There's no doubt that as we age, the body's ability to detect rogue cells diminishes, and so that's a challenge for us. If we think of lifestyle factors, the big ticket item there is tobacco. It causes more cancers than any other lifestyle factor, and it's not just lung cancer. It's cancer of the mouth, cancer of the throat. It affects cancers in bladder, pancreas. It really affects our whole body in so many ways. And if we can continue to reduce our smoking rates, we will have an impact on cancer. Other lifestyle factors do include our use of alcohol, our diet, our exercise, and obesity levels. All of the things that cause lifestyle-related problems with heart disease, with lung disease, are just the same with cancer. And all of us have the ability to make decisions that can improve our lifestyle and reduce our lifetime risk of cancer.